So the savory rice cakes I'm gonna make are gonna be bacon and eggs, kind of breakfast style. So I'm not gonna teach you how to make scrambled eggs. I hope by now you know how to do it, but if you don't know, just email me and I'll make you a video about scrambling eggs. But I'm gonna show you how I like to cook the bacon. So I'm using regular bacon. But what happens when you cook the bacon, sometimes it just burns and crisps up before all the fat renders out of the bacon. So I have my bacon here and I have water. So I'm gonna turn my heat on the like high heat, and I'm gonna wait for the water to come to a simmer and then evaporate and then crisp up the bacon. What happens is it delays the crisping up or the browning of the bacon and allows the extra fat from the bacon to render out in the water. The water is very little, eventually evaporates, but then you'll have a more crispy bacon and less fat in it in the final result. So yeah, let's keep an eye on this. Okay, so as you can see, all the water has evaporated, so now is the time for the fat and the bacon to crisp up. So I'm gonna lower the heat because I don't want it to go too high. And it's just a matter of time until the bacon is nice and crispy. Once I'm happy and it's nicely brown and all crisp up, I have a paper towel here on a plate, and I'm just gonna drain the extra fat. And that's it for the bacon. Then we chop the bacon and it's gonna be ready for the rice cakes. Some savory rice cakes. So I have the rice here. As you can see, it's perfectly cooked. I'm gonna show you the pan so you can see it didn't scorch, it didn't do anything, it just cooked perfectly. So the savory rice cakes, sometimes the sweet ones I put them in the food processor, but the savory ones I don't think it's needed. There's nothing to blend pretty much, but you still want to do it while the rice is nice and warm, because it's gonna help, especially with the sugar and the salt, to make sure it's dissolved, you know, evenly. So I'm gonna add the sugar, and I'm using dark brown sugar. We're gonna add also a little pinch of sea salt. I have some Portuguese sea salt here. And I'm not gonna add a lot of it because we're gonna add some soy sauce. And the soy sauce is gonna give that kind of savoriness and saltiness to our rice. And just combine it with your spatula. I also have here the scrambled eggs. I'm just gonna put a towel underneath my bowl so it's not sliding and dancing around. So I'm gonna add the scrambled eggs. And because we're gonna crumble them anyway, it's one of those cases, if you over dry your scrambled eggs when you cook them, it's perfectly fine. It doesn't really matter in this case. And you kinda wanna smoosh the rice a little bit, combining with everything else. And I'm gonna add the bacon. I chopped the bacon, so it's nicely fine. Just a quick tip when it comes to cooking bacon, if you like to cook with the bacon fat, or even if you don't, the best way to store it or discard it is actually to line a little bowl with some foil, and then you pour the bacon fat in there, and then it will eventually become solid once it's cool, because it's animal fat, and you can either store it and cook with it or just discard it. Because if you just discard it, you know, down the drain, it can clog your drain. So you don't want to do that. So that's the proper way to do it. And if you like the flavor, you can save it and cook it later. So bacon here, nicely crisp. Let's go add it in. And that's pretty much it. I would recommend, you know, give it a taste, because this is your rice cakes. It's for you to enjoy. So you might want a little bit of extra sugar, maybe some maple syrup, maybe you want a little extra salt. So it's really a matter of, you know, customize it. You can even, you know, combine instead of the eggs, add maybe some almond butter, anything you like. Once you know how to cook the rice, you can really play with the flavorings. So now that the mixture is done, I usually use this aluminum foil pans because they're really convenient. Each batch gives me two, and it's 8 by 8 inch, so it's really easy then to portion the cakes. But you don't have to buy anything like this. I'm pretty sure everyone has like a baking dish at home or something like that. 8 by 8 is a good size, or if you're doing it, you know, a bigger one, double. It doesn't ooze, it's not a runny mixture, so you can actually, if you have just a big tray, just, you know, use half of it and just pack it in to the size you want. So I'm just gonna put this here and really tuck it in, so really press it so it gets nice and compact, because once you wrap it, and you don't want it to be crumbly, you wanna, you know, not to have to stop your bike ride or whatever you're doing to eat your rice cakes. I'll be honest, I actually would eat this for breakfast because it has rice, it has soy sauce, it has eggs. Not very fond of the bacon, but maybe you can usually actually add, you know, turkey bacon or even some vegetarian bacon if you prefer. But I'm guessing most of you actually like the regular bacon. So for the sweet version of the rice cakes, I add toppings as like a little bit of chocolate and peanuts, which are the flavors we're using. Here, I'm not gonna add obviously any of that, but I'm gonna sprinkle a little extra with some brown sugar. Just gives a little bit of crunch, and it's not about the sweetness, it's a little bit of the crunch. And to balance that, I'm gonna add a little bit of the salt. And I'm gonna use sea salt, and it's kind of the fleur de sel, so the really, the nice crystals of salt. It gives you the saltiness, but also a little bit of texture. This is obviously optional, gives a little extra flavor to the rice cakes. And that's pretty much it. Now you wanna let them cool at room temperature, and once they're nicely cooled, put them in the fridge so they really set up. And once they're firm, you can portion them and wrap them. And we'll come back later for that.